Located 3 hours out of Melbourne, Victoria, Beechworth Hospital was founded in 1867 and was one of the largest hospitals in the country. Able to hold a capacity of 1,200 patients, it wasn't uncommon that overcrowding would become an issue. Patients would have to die in order to free up a bed or be released into society far worse off than when they were originally committed. As a result of the overcrowding, nurses and doctors were stretched to the max, so the care had a lot to be desired, so much so that patients went missing and were found dead weeks later in weird places. Those held within the asylum included the mentally ill, intellectually disabled, and the elderly suffering from dementia. However, due to common misconception, you could find yourself committed for being in the wrong place at the wrong time, or for simply being different and not adapting to the normality of society in that period of time. Compared to today's standards and evaluation practices, it only required 2 signatures to have a person condemned for their actions. It is foretold that grueling shock treatments would be practiced in the building's feared Grevillea wing. As medication had not been introduced into the hospital until the 1950s, in some instances the entire population would experience these treatments. When these treatments were administered, the patients' bodies either splayed out backwards with force or contracted inwards into a fetal position, with such intensity that ligaments would snap, bones would break, and teeth shattered. It is said in the Grevillea wing, an apparition of an unknown male doctor can be seen wandering the corridors at night, as well as Matron Sharp, a nurse who worked at the hospital and sat with patients who were about to receive such treatment. Witnesses have told of the room being icy cold, with the presence of her comforting spirit, which at one time brought reassurance to her patients. Another infamous sighting on the wing is that of the shadowy figure of the kneeling girl, which was caught by photographer Gaurav Tiwari. Not much is known about this girl. A lot of questions have been raised, most notably, who or what is she hiding from? Take a trip to the hospital's kitchen and recreation area, and you may be lucky to feel the sensation of Tommy Kennedy. A former well-liked patient who worked and died in the kitchen area, he is said to tug at people's clothing or poke them in the ribs. The recreation hall was an area for the patients to sing, play music, or perform in plays, and on Sundays the hall would double up as a chapel. In 1939, the hall became a cinema for the inmates. There are 2 ghosts that have been caught here. One ghost is that of a young girl who approaches women and desperately tries to communicate with them. The other ghost commonly seen is an elderly man facing away from the window that was once a part of the bell tower. Another wing of the hospital famous for sightings and an overwhelming negative presence is the bullpen. This area housed young males aged 18 to 25 who are extremely troubled and aggressive. Reports of slamming doors and footsteps have been regularly reported in this area, as well as visitors being told to get out. Another distinctive and cruel feature of the building was what doctors and nurses later named the Ha-Ha Wall. This consisted of a vertical wall which presented the illusion of being smaller than it actually was. As a result, desperate patients would regularly attempt to escape these premises while nurses and doctors looked on and laughed at the futile attempts. It's also been reported that the apparition of a chain-smoking patient who was thrown out of her window to her death by another patient who wanted her cigarettes can be seen. It's also said that the woman was Jewish, so the staff at the hospital could not move her body until it was seen by a rabbi. She was left lying out the front of the hospital for 2 days whilst the rabbi travelled to Melbourne. Local residents who live nearby have seen the ghost of a man wearing a green woolen jacket. It is believed that this is the spirit of Arthur, who worked the gardens for many years and earned 10 shillings a week. He wore his green jacket all year round, and no one could persuade him otherwise. After he died, the nurses found over 4 years' worth of wages secretly hidden in the seams of his jacket. The reason for this is unknown. One of the more gruesome tales about the history of the hospital is that of a patient who disappeared. Despite the hard efforts by staff to find him, there was no trace to be found of the elusive patient. Several weeks after the disappearance, his location was finally discovered when the resident dog Max was found chewing a severed leg near the gatehouse at the grounds entry. A second search commenced and the body was found in a tree. The body had decomposed so badly that his leg had fallen off. The spirit of the patient has been seen in the early hours of the morning near the entrance to the asylum. In 1995, the hospital was decommissioned after 128 years of operation, and is now a site for regular ghost tours and for those who are willing to test their courage and stay the night on the grounds. All those who stay the night can leave with a sense of relief that their stay is only temporary. Sadly, this can't be said for those spirits who are trapped within the walls of the now dormant asylum. Hi guys, thanks for watching today's video. This is a part of the Homegrown Horror series where I cover all things paranormal, unexplained in this wonderful land we call Australia. If you like what you saw, please subscribe. Feel free to follow me on Twitter and Facebook as well. The link is below. Seeing that it's January 1st, Happy New Year. I hope everyone has a safe, wonderful New Year, and I hope to bring you more content throughout this wonderful year as well. Thank you very much.